Hey guys, how's it going? Heather Lynn from Holy Fit here. I've got your Holy Fit Daily Sweat, and the whole purpose of this is to give you a short, quick workout that you could do anywhere so that you can fit a little physical activity into your day, because we all need that. You'd be surprised at how much energy you get from doing a little bit of physical activity and what it does for your mindset. If you're having a really crappy day and you're feeling a little bit down, try doing a quick little workout, and it'll turn things around for you. You'll at least have a little break from whatever's bugging you for the time that you're working out, because if you're working out hard enough, you're not going to be able to focus on anything else. It's just such a healthy way to deal with any kind of depression or anxiety you might be feeling, or anger or anything like that. It's a great way to really clear your head. And I share this with a few groups, which is what I'm doing right now, so bear with me. It'll just take me a couple more seconds here. There we go. I hope you're having a good day, but you know, if you're having a little bit of a frustrating one, like I said, a little workout, that'll do it for you. I can't tell you how many times I've been able to take my frustration out during my workouts, which is unfortunate for the people that are taking my class, because usually the workouts are just a little bit tougher when I'm having a bad day. Just so you know. All right, just got to share this with a couple more groups here. And I always put the list of exercises that I do in the comments below. So if you're not sure what the exercises are, just check the comments below, and that way you don't have to write down the exercises, because that's a pain in the butt. Okay, and I got one more to do after this, and then I'll show you the workout. Make sure that you warm up. So if you're going to do the workout, warm up before you start. You want to warm up for a good 5 to 10 minutes before you start. Super important, you guys. You don't want to injure yourself. And it'll feel bad if you do it cold. I promise you, it'll feel better if you're warm. So make sure you take the time to do that warm up. And that could be anything. You could be, you could hop on a stationary bike if you've got one handy, go for a little walk, or just move your body around for 5 to 10 minutes just to get a little bit warmer. Hey, Julie, how's it going? So I'm gonna show you the exercises now. This is a good one. So make sure that you're nice and warmed up. For the workout, it's gonna be 3 sets in total. For each exercise, you're going to go 45 seconds for the exercise, take a 15 second break, and then do the next exercise. You're taking a 15 second break between exercises. Once you get through all of them, take a minute or two to recover before you do the next set. Or maybe today is the kind of day where you only want to do one set, and that's fine. So any little bit of physical activity is going to be beneficial. So you're all warmed up. Your first exercise is burpee side jump. So you plant your hands, you jump back, you jump in, go to the side. Jump back, jump in, go to the side. Option, plant your hands, walk back, walk in, stand up tall, take a step over. Walk back, walk in, stand up, take a step over. Okay, so high or low impact. 45 seconds, they got a 15 second little breather, let your heart rate settle a little bit. Coming down to the floor for some bicycle crunches. So you're on your back. Opposite shoulder, going towards that knee, getting that nice twist, supporting your head, not pulling on it. Make sure when you're doing this, you've got some space between your chin and your chest so you're not hurting your neck. So you have 45 seconds of that, get a 15 second break, and you're back up on your feet. 45 seconds of reverse lunges, so you're just stepping back into a nice lunge, step forward, step back. Make sure that you are stepping back far enough so that that front knee is over your ankle, not over your toes. You're able to push through the heel, squeeze your butt at the same time. All right, so 45 seconds of that, 15 second break. Then come into a plank. So on your elbows, make sure your elbows are under your shoulders. If you have back issues or shoulder issues, bring your knees down to the ground for a little extra support. Hold that for 45 seconds. Take your 15 second breather. Stand up, and you got high knees. 45 seconds of high knees. You can do non-impact if you prefer. 15 second break, and then back onto the floor. Reverse crunches. So you're on your back. You're gonna lift your tailbone off the floor, bring your feet back towards the floor.
This is the full range of motion. If you don't want to do the full range of motion, you can shorten it up a little bit, especially if you have a sensitive low back. So 45 seconds of that, 15 second break, back up onto your feet, and you've got froggy jumps. So froggy jumps, you take a nice wide stance, knees and toes are facing out. If you can touch the floor, great, jump up. If the floor is too low, just come down, bring your hands to your knees wherever you want. You don't have to go all the way to the floor. Non-impact, come down, up on the toes, down, up on the toes. 45 seconds of that, 15 second recovery. And then finally, your last exercise is an up-down plank with an optional push-up. So you don't have to do that push-up, it's just optional. Up-down plank, high plank, elbow under shoulder, palms under shoulder. Down, down, up, up. If you want to add the push-up, you go down, down, up, up, push-up. Down, down, up, up, push-up. That's optional. And you can do that with your knees on the ground for a little extra support. So remember to do that if you have any low back issues, or if you have shoulder issues, you might just find that it's a little bit better to have the extra support with your knees on the ground. So that's it. 45 seconds of each exercise, 15 seconds in between to rest. 3 sets in total, or like I said, maybe you just want to do 1 or 2, that's okay. Make sure you rest for about a minute or two before you start the circuit again. So give yourself a chance to cool down, have some water, towel off if you need to, and then start again. And that's it. And then once you're done, you're going to want to do your stretches. So you're going to lie on your back, because you're going to want to lie down after that. And starting with the hamstring stretch. Leg up, grab above or below the knee joint. Bottom leg can be straight if you want. Top leg needs to be straight to get that nice hamstring stretch. One side and then the other side. You're holding these 20 to 30 seconds minimum. Then you're going to cross one leg over, pull the other leg in, getting a good stretch in those glutes. And then you can roll over onto your side, grab your ankle, pull your heel up towards your glutes to stretch out the quadricep. I like to stagger my legs. I find I get a better stretch that way. Make sure you get them both. Make sure you're holding them for long enough. I'm showing you them really quickly here. Normally I hold my stretches probably more than 30 seconds. I like a good stretch. Feet together, knees out to the side. Great inner thigh stretch. And then you can also, I like to do this lat stretch after each exercise or each workout. I find it makes me feel like I'm lengthening my body again. One side and the other side. And then opening up your chest, either clasp your hands behind your back or put them on the floor and press your chest forward. And that's it. That's the entire workout. So give it a go, try it out. If you just do one set, it'll only take you like maybe 10 minutes at the most to do the whole thing with the warm up and the cool down and everything. So it doesn't hurt to do a little bit. You don't have to do a long workout to get benefits. So try it out. If you have any comments, please feel free to share them. If you want to message me privately to talk more, I'm more than happy to chat. So please feel free to do that if you want to. Hey, Shannon, how's it going? So I gotta run. Hope you guys are having a great day, and I'll see you again tomorrow.